Hey folks, I'm Sir Vainglory, and welcome to part 10 of my Greenskins campaign in Total War Warhammer. In the last part, we managed to defeat an army led by Cazador Dragonslayer, but we couldn't kill him or wound him because he managed to outrun our Goblin Wolf Riders, which is an impressive feat for a dwarf. However, it has given us a bit of the initiative now, and I reckon that he'll be reforming an army in Karak Azul as soon as he can. We have this army here, which we did have a mission to defeat, but I think we missed out on that in the last part. We still have two strong armies under remnants of our Wa. So I think what I would want to do, I might send Ornery down to retake Crooked Fang Fort, send Grimgor after this army towards Karak Azul so we can besiege that as quickly as possible and prevent them from recruiting too many troops. And then, if we're successful there, then we can retake, or we can take this southern province. And that would give us control of most of the southeastern corner of the map. So we're at the end of the turn, so we're just going to move ahead then. Okay, so Clan Angrind have offered us peace twice before and have declined each time on the basis that they're so far from us that they weren't a threat. But the last time I declined, that led to Karak Azul allying with them and joining the war against us. So I'm going to accept the peace treaty this time, and that leaves us, or should leave us, to deal with Karak Azul on our own terms. Don't know whether they would actually peace out. I don't think so at this point, because they're quite strong, quite a number of provinces. So anyway, we'll accept that and see how we go from there. Okay, so we are still at war with them. Right, let's get Grimgor moving. If I move too quickly, there is the danger that we could run into an ambush. So we're going to move our hero forward to scout out the area for us. It seems safe enough, so we'll march Grimgor up.
Yes, boss.
The embedded hero. Okay. And the Wa will follow along behind. The Wa with Ornery's army. Oh no, that's Ornery. Is it? I'm confused. No, yeah, that's Ornery. Okay, that's fine. So Grimgor should be strong enough to take this settlement. Just put him into normal stance. Are they in range to reinforce? I don't think they are. Which is fine. So we'll just come in and attack. And our Wa should come in at the end of the turn and in a position to reinforce if they do come up for us.
I'm the one true king.
Okay. I'm going to auto-resolve this because it is so heavily outnumbered this time. We'll have a battle later, I'm sure. Okay. Small amount of money, but the settlement's most important. Did get the Scarecrow banner and gained a rank, and we will occupy the settlement. That's good. So they're now in our territory. I don't think I'm going to send a Wa after them.
Stop that!
I don't think they'd be able to damage them too much. We can just use them as a reinforcing unit. And terms of building, we've got plenty of cash. I haven't done much building in the last wee while. So let's have a look at Crooked Fine Fort. And I do want to upgrade. We'll go for growth rather than 200 extra income. We're doing okay for money just now. Don't really need another army at this point, so we will take the idols. Obedience 100, which is fantastic. Let's just have a quick look and see the other settlements. Crack, minus 46, but it's at 0, so we're doing okay in terms of obedience just now, which is good. And I think Karak Azul is the only faction that we're still at war with. Yep. Okay. So, that's us then. Let's move on. Oh, Grimgor has the skill point. Now I was working on choppers, so I'll just continue there. Move on this time. So the army has disappeared. Decisive defeat. Negative growth at Iron Rock. So where did that wah go then? Where was the defeat? Strange. Anyway.
You what?
So, as I said, let's get Karak Azul under siege. Well, we can't reach it this turn. Oh, we can, I think. So you go up there and under siege.
For a scrap.
Now they're not actually building an army there. So we may as well just fight this battle then. Oh no, we need to besiege it. I think my battery's about to go in my mouse. Let's take the tower as well, just for the sake of it. And continue the siege. And with Grimgor. Let's. How far can you get? There's a bit of replenishment still required in some of the units, so we'll stay just within our own borders for just now. How about buying another unit? Another rock lobber? I don't think. So, not for this army. So, we'll just leave it at that for the moment. And let's move on to the next turn. Actually, before we do that, I'm going to pause recording just now and replace the mouse battery. I'll be back in a sec. Okay, so we're good to go. Normally, the battery runs out in the middle of a battle. As I'm sure happens around the world, so I'm quite glad that it happened. We got a wee warning before we ended up in the middle of a combat situation. Okay, so we've discovered an ambusher. Up here, we've got another turn before we can attack. Well, we could attack just now, but I want to complete the siege tower. With Grimgor, this guy was trying to ambush us, I believe. So I'm just going to try and bait him. Let's make sure that we're not within any sort of reinforcement zone. Let's come to here and do some breathing. And that's us for just now. this guy's off to. Okay, so we're now able to assault here.
Don't think so.
Just going to keep Grimgor there, taking the income. Actually, we might move him along a bit. Just to there. Because I do want to bring this army back down, so that rejoin them. Now, in terms of building, the only building we've got available is in Crooked Fang Fort. And again, we can upgrade here. We've got plenty of cash, so we'll take a totem pole, and our obedience is fine for just now. So we will go with the pile of shiny stuff. Once we've got that built up, then we can revisit what we've got in Karak Eight Peaks. Now let's see. Yep, so let's fight this battle then.
This is gonna be messy.
Okay. So just about, it is half and half, missile units and infantry. Let's get our archers. Lined up. Stairs fine. Who has the... you guys, I don't want you with the equipment. I actually want... spears. To take those. One of your boys to take the ram. And we're going to put the one of the towers here. The other tower we'll just have in here. The one obviously in the middle for the gate. Group up spider riders and keep them back here. I want to actually group these guys up. And they can reinforce as soon as the towers are in place. Yep, that unit. Reinforce them. And that leaves us with these guys here. We're going to have... no, we'll just stick them in along there with the cav for the moment. And our bosses just in there. Okay, so let's start the battle. Get moving forward as quickly as we can. Get our archers. Fine there. Get Grimgor and Ornery. Well, that's actually so it is, it's Ornery. It's not great armor and hit points. So we'll leave him back just now rather than use him to attract any tower fire. They want to get these orc boys moving forward. Same with these. These guys. You taking out them? We'll fire it, will. Well, these sort boys got to move on. To them. You also get to them. I'm going to send lords forward and get the rest of our infantry moving up. You get up here to them. You archers. You move to them. And this infantry. You get moving forward. Double fast. Actually, you come in here. Are there any units? Yep. That's their general. Get him in on them as well. Yep, shoot at them. Up here, you guys come down to here. Take them. Archers, switch targets. You guys charge into them. You also come into them. Them. Let's get our archers up here now. I'll get some of them up here. You two are in the best shape. You get up there. Spears are drooping here. That's okay. Shoot at them as well. Any targets for you guys? Shoot there. Actually, shoot at those long beards, there's only two of them left. Okay, right, so let's get Gorfine and Ornery into the town centre. Let's get our Spider Riders to come in here also. These guys up here. Still not going. So we will be done fairly soon. Need to get some guys up here to deal with these. I can't believe this guy's still not down. There he goes. Let's bring Omri back. Do a bit of damage up here if we can. A tough battle. Fitting victory, that's fine. We lost a hell of a lot of orcs, but that's given us their capital. We should be able to quickly replenish that army. Money. That talisman of endurance, that's good. Didn't quite make the next rank, so we're going to occupy. So 15% word save for Ornery. That'll help tank in the future. And let's to those guys. And where's those guys? Okay, let's see what we have in Karak Azul. So I've got a couple of building slots. And I think I will build some recruiting buildings here. Yeah, I think ditches at the moment. Yeah. Just for the garrison, really. Just to give that bit of protection just now while we're still at war. And I think that's probably us for now then. Okay. That'll do us then, let's move on. Scorfang has his skill. Yeah, got our fighter. Character skill selection, is this character more effective at slaying enemy characters? Excellent. Oh, I just remembered we have a hero. Don't we? Where do we have this hero? Well, I thought we had it. Did we not have a big boss? Or was it just that he's available? Yeah, I think it was. Okay, who's this? Cazador the Orcbane? This Cazador the Sprinter? Okay, this could be a bit more problematic then.
What?
And this is Barondin the Astute. So they have, it looks like, two full stacks plus another army under recruitment here. So we're going to then bring Ornery's army. Now, actually, just bring his army back down here, still within our own lands, because he does need to
recruit a
few units there, that's fine. And Grimgor, you can just continue there. Let's see what Gorfang can do against this guy. I can fail to assassinate him.
Mork says what?
Mork says assassinate him next time. And Karak Azul. Yep, let's spend the money on the Brawling Grounds. We can do some building at Black Crag. Upgrade to a Greenskin fort. And then Crooked Fang. What can we do here? So Crooked Fang, we might actually lose a settlement again. So I'm not going to invest in it right now. I wonder if they would accept a peace treaty just now. Probably not. It just allows some time to sort of reform our armies. But then also gives them, and I think we need to keep the pressure on, so I'll leave that for just now. Okay, so I'm going to put a cut in here. We'll pick it up again in the next turn. I hope that you guys have enjoyed this. Please comment, rate and subscribe if you're enjoying the series, and I hope to see you next time. Cheers.